Depicted by Buddha, అంతఃకరణ మైండ్ చిత్తం. See the distinction between the chit and chittam. Chit, Chaitanya Tattva, pure awareness principle, consciousness principle, Atma. Chittam is antakarana. See, antakarana consists of mana, buddhi, ahankara, chittam. One chittam is there. That chittam is faculty of recollection. Otherwise, entire antakarana also is called as chittam. Sometimes it's called mind, sometimes it's called buddhi. We have to see the context and determine what exactly is meant by the word chittam, etc. These three things are told. Now let us see now.
Sri Bhagavan Uvacha.
Sri Bhagavan Uvacha.
Iti Nirvasana Tvena. Jivanmuktasayarjuna.
Jivanmuktasayarjuna.
Antasitalatametya.
Antasitalatametya.
Bandhudukkhamalam dhyaya.
Bandhudukkhamalam dhyaya.
Anvaya. Arjuna. Iti nirvasanatvena jivanmuktataya antaha shitalatam etya bandhudukham alam tyaja.
Arjuna, listen. Iti. Iti means thus, in this manner. What manner? As I had told you in the earlier chapter. Krishna may not have made chapters there. The one who has compiled has made the chapter. Just now what I taught you, in the manner I taught you just now. Iti nirvasanatvena. Being yourself free from vasanas. Now tell me, what is that iti? In this manner, having got yourself, being totally free, got rid of all the vasanas. Now tell me, what is that iti in this manner? What did Lord Krishna say? Vasanas can end only in atmajnana. Is what I told. Vasanas can get ended only in atmajnana. Therefore, he says, iti, in this manner, having got the atmajnana, brahmajnana, whereby having destroyed all vasanas, nirvasanatvena, as a result, who are you now? Jivanmuktataya. Having accomplished Jivan Mukti. Having accomplished Jivan Mukti. What is Jivan Mukti? Before that, what we should know? What is Mukti? What is Mukti?
Liberation.
Sabdhuisas was going there. Oh, I came to the class. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Mukti. Freedom. Is it that way? Mukti is freedom. What is that mukti? Freedom, that is true. Why you want to abide in yourself, swasarupa? You want to get freed from the sorrows of samsara, is it not? You want to get freed from limitations and sorrows of samsara. Vedanta comes and tells you, you have to gain the atmajnana, your swarupa is totally free from samsara, you have to discover that. Is it not? There is a, now, if you don't get the knowledge, you get subjected to sukha-dukha of the jagat. That is what is called as what? Samsara. So now, here is a person who is still alive, at the same time he has got the Atma, he is interacting with the world, we also interact with the world. What is our outcome? Rush to Vedanta class, so that's something. Some relief will be there from the samsara sorrow. Is it not? No. He has discovered his swarupa, that is ananda, in light of which sukha dukkhas doesn't mean anything to him. They are totally incapable of making him a sorrowful entity. They are totally incapable of sorrowful entity. Why? Mind is where centered? In the ananda sarupa, that is atma brahma. As a common man, what happens? We get subjected to sorrows on account of I do this, kartrutva. I enjoy this, I suffer this, bhoktrutva. Sukha, dukkha, mana, apamana, diseases, all hunger, thirst. Because of all this, we get what? Subjected to affliction. Where do you experience this affliction? In what part of the body you suffer? Antakarana, mind. So therefore, this sukha-dukha afflictions are at the level of what? Chittam, not chit. Antakarana, this is it. Now this person who has got knowledge, in spite of all these sukha dukkha which are bound to come to him on account of his prarabdha karma, still he is what? Mentally not afflicted. It is not a psychic trait. Don't think that way. Some people have got that is strength of the mind. It is not that way. His mind is so absorbed in the sarupa, first thing he doesn't have the awareness of the body. When you are not aware of the body, are you going to get afflicted by the pain in the body? See, suppose you are very much engrossed in some work and actually you are hungry, time has already gone, hungry. But you are so much engrossed, you don't feel hunger. But that work stops, then suddenly what happens? Oh. So you feel hungry. Earlier hunger was there and yet you could not, you see, because mind was where? So that way, the mind of the Jivan Mukta is preoccupied in the Swarupa, which is Ananda Swarupa. To that extent, he is impervious of Sukha Dukkha in the life. He is impervious of Sukha Dukkha in the life. As a result, what happens? There are no klesha, afflictions, pain in the antakarana. So he is called the Jivan Mukta. Not simply Jivan Api Mukta. Even while living is Mukta. What you Mukta, nobody knows. They are not that. So this is what it is. Jivan Mukta. In Bhagavad Gita, now you may say, here Lord is trying to describe Jivan Mukti. Why did he not describe Bhagavad Gita? Did he not know Bhagavad Gita will be more popular? then Arjuna Upakhyana, because Yoga Vashta is a very voluminous thing. Who is going to take this? He has described. Not at one place, at three places in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna has described the Jivan Mukta. Only thing, the word Jivan Mukta is not used there. The words used there are different. Second chapter, you are familiar with the Siddha Prajna. This Siddha Prajna is Jivan Mukta. 14th chapter, you know Gunatita. This Gunatita is a Jivan Mukta. 12th chapter is the Bhakta. That Bhakta is who? Jivan Mukta. Vyasa in Mahabharata had described, who is called as Brahmana. That Brahmana also is who? Jivan Mukta. suffer. Bhagavad Gita does describe Jivan Mukti as Siddha Prajna, Gunatita and Bhakta. Let us see. Jivan Muktataya. Because what before that we are trying to see what is Mukti. Before that we should know what is Bandha. And everybody tied your hands and legs, put you behind the bars, and you say you are bound. The chitta klesha that you had seen so far, affliction of the mental, that is bandha. Afflictions of the mind getting subjected to joys, sorrows, etc., that is bandha. And now this Jivan Mukti is what? He has no such sukha dukkha, etc., because of the direct knowledge of the Swarupa. So therefore, so Nivaranam, warding off the sukha dukkha klesha at the chitta level, that is what is called as Jivan Mukti. So therefore, what is happened now? In Nirvasana and he, Jivan Mukta Taya, being a Jivan Mukta person, Arjuna do this. What is it? Antaha Sheetalatam Etya. Antaha, inside. Inside where? In the Antakarana. Sheetalatam Etya. Being very cool. What do you imagine? I think Atma Jnana means along with that an air conditioner comes. Inbuilt air conditioner where? In the mind. And you are all cool. What is the sense? Antaha Sheetalatam. Being cool means calm and composed. Sheetalata also means Icharahityam. But that cool means freedom from Icha desires. You want to be hot at the mental level? Entertain more desires and try to strive for to fulfill them. Then what will happen? Agitation. That is what is called a lack of Sheetalata. Antashirtata metya means having got the very tranquil mind, very calm and composed mind, Shanta mind. Free from Icha desires. Itya. What do you do? Bandhu dukkham alam teja. Teja, give up. What? Alam, totally. See, alam has got different meanings. Alam also means enough. And suppose, you went to somebody's house and the hostess is serving you. So, enough. There are different tones of enough. First enough is for etiquette. But hostess knows it. She puts it. Hey, enough is there. And when there is a real enough, come. Hey, what? So enough. That is what it is. But here it is. Purna, totally. Say alam, that is totally bandhu dukkham teja. What is bandhu dukkha? Sorrows on account of relatives. See, there is one word has to be added. Bandhu vada dukkham. Bandhu vada dukkham. But Vada means what? Killing. See, this is a compound where one word is elided. It is called Madhyama Pada Lopa Samasa. Samasa, a compound wherein in between one word is what? Removed. For example, Shaka Parthivaha. Parthiva means king. Shaka means vegetables. What is vegetable king? A king who likes vegetables. Puja Swami used to give an example. Coffee Srinivasa. Who is Coffee Srinivasa? Coffee Priya Srinivasa. Mr. Srinivasa was very fond of what? Coffee. Coffee Srinivasa. So like that, one bandhu vada dukkham. The sorrows on account of killing the kith and kin, that's called as what? Bandhu dukkham. You are aware that. First chapter, Arjuna was inconsolable. How am I to kill all my gurus and kith and kin, etc.? So that, alam teja. Why? Where is your mind? You are not aware of the body, etc., absorbed in the sarupa. Sarupa, alam teja. Further.
Jara marana nishankaha.
Akasha
vishadashayaha.
Akasha vishadashayaha.
Yatteshtanishta sankalpaha.
Yatteshtanishta sankalpaha.
Vitarago bhavanaha. Anvaya, anaka, jara marana nishankaha, akasha vishadashayaha, tyakta ishta anishta sankalpaha, vitaragaha bhava.
So, in the wake of knowledge, to have the shitalata of the mind, all these are necessary. What are those things? Anagha. Agha means sin. Agham na vidyate yasya anagha. One who doesn't have sin, sinless. Arjuna was a sinless person. What is the proof? What the proof? Number one, Krishna was his friend. Number two, Lord Krishna chose to teach Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna. That shows. Don't ask that Dharmaraja was not said, Anaga. Yes, Anaga. But that frame of, that ready frame of mind he didn't have. Arjuna could foresee the calamity. Dharmaraja, no, he wanted to get the kingdom. But after war was over, he was inconsolable. But Arjuna didn't see, he was before the war. So, other things, Dharanarayana, all those things are there. So there is this. Anagha, O sinless Arjuna, jara marana nishankaha, son. Son means being nishankaha. Nishankaha is fearless. Being fearless about what? Jara and marana. Is there fear about old age? Old age and death or not? In more torturous conditions. See, many desires are there, but the body is not fit to fulfill the desires. Jara, jara and marana. Upalakshana for all dukkhas that come in the life. These are the peak of sorrow. Old age, and death. Jaramarana Nishanka, being fearless. Being fearless. Why he is fearless? When you are afraid of these two, Jaramarana belongs to whom?
Body.
He is not aware of the body. He is means, totally absorbed in the Swarupa. See, what's it happened? You know, there was a great sage Rubhu. Rubhu is Manasaputra Brahmani like Vasishtha. He had a great disciple called Nidaga. He called great disciple Nidaga. So this Nidaga was really, but totally steeped in Karmakanda. Rubhu many times taught him, look, final reality is what? Atma Sarupa, Brahma Sarupa, Advaita. You have to rise above the karma. Karma have their role up to certain point, gaining antakarana, shuddhi. Rubhu was not that convinced. So he was in his own place, etc. So, but Rubhu, Nidaga, Rubhu was aware that he is a great person, he is eligible to gain the knowledge. One day, he came in the disguise of some different Brahmana. Nidaga had just finished the Vaishvadeva, the ahutis for the this thing, ritual, and he was standing at the door, expecting any atithi to come. He said, come, 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 come. So, what food you would like? Then he said, what have you got? He told him, cha-cha-cha-cha-cha. This of course. I want all sweet pudding and this and this. So he told him, prepare quickly. He wants it. So he went prepared. Then he asked, Aditi, are you satisfied with the food given? Look, one who is hungry gets satisfied. I had no hunger. He has eaten. I have no hunger. I know I can't have hunger. Which I refer to? Atma. Had I received, it will come that way. So there is no, I have removed it. Other time it happened. Rubhu came in the form of a rustic, just village folk. And Nidaga was seeing the procession of the king. King was riding on an elephant, and a big peripheral, he was just looking at. So he came, what is that going on? A king is going on. King? Where is that king? There, on the riding on the elephant. What is that elephant? What is that elephant? Below the king is who? Elephant, and he is on the elephant. What is this below and above? Nidaga got angry. Come on, bend down. He said, please, I don't know, I am an uneducated person, please don't get angry with me, etc. So he bent down. He sat on it. Now, did you understand? You are below me, I am above you. Yes, sir. I understood what is above, what is below, who is king, and what is elephant. But you spoke, I and you, what are those I and you? You spoke of I and you. What are those I and you? Nidaga understood. This fellow is not an ordinary guy. He frustrated. He said, I am Rubhu. Because such fundamental questions nobody can ask at all. Who is I and who is you? So that is how it happened. So that's fine. So freedom, that means no identity. So long as your identity within the body is there, So that we are the hunger will be there, appeasing hunger will be there, etc. So now, you are not identified other thing. Not identified with the body means what? Get up early in the morning, sit, I am not the body. I am not the body. And it will be japa. So, by Viveka Vairagya Chasana Sadhaja Sampatti, take to Vedanta exposure Shravanamana, purify the mind, make the mind just like what? Atma Swarupa. Wherein what? What is there is only Atma Swarupa. Neither the body nor the jagat. What happens? Deha Tadatmya drops. How it drops? Like a person sleeping who has hold a lotus in the hand. What is the remedy for getting Deha Tadatmya? Not that I am not the body. Intensify Nididhyasa. What you have to do is what? Intensify Nididhyasana. If Nididhyasana is less, Deha Tadatmya is a habit, it is going continued. It has to be scrapped by what? Nididhyasana. So in any case. Now here, he is so absorbed in the Swarupa, he is absorbed in the Swarupa. He says, Jaramarana Nishankaha, fearless about the old age. You see, because he is not the body, he is absorbed in the Swarupa. And Akasha Vishadashayaha. Ashaya means here receptacle. Receptacle means ashraya, means chittam, antakarna, mind. We say, whatever ashaya chittam, akasha vishada. Vishada means clear. Clean, like what? Akasha. What does it mean? Like means, see, mind which is like Akasha. That is what it means is, Akasha doesn't get attached, connected to anything whatsoever. Come on, tell me, therefore, what is called Akasha is called as what? A Sangha. Sangha is not there. A Sangha. Akasha the Sangha. Not connected. So, what a public toilet. Akasha is not foul. It's what it is. Air may be polluted. So, a Sangha. We say this air, this is space pollution. Space can never get polluted. What gets polluted is air. But we superimpose that air pollution on what? Space. That means Akasha is asanga, unconnected, not connected to anything whatsoever. Asanga. Thus Akasha Vishana. Vishana clear? Asha. That means, see, means that mind is as asanga as the Akasha space. Vishadashya. As a result, what happens? Tekta ishta nishta sankalpa. Mind is asanga, is not connected, or whatever. Desires, etc., are not there. Tekta, one has given up. Sankalpa. What is sankalpa? Manovyapara. Functions of the mind. You see, this sankalpa word has got many meanings. You know, puja vidhat or sankalpa. For this purpose, I nishchay. Sankalpa. Any thought, sankalpa. A desire is sankalpa. Identifying the body, deha tadatmya, sankalpa. In short, you have to see in the context, you can thought also. Manovyapara. Functions of the mind, sankalpa. And now what type of functions here? Ishta, anishta. Madhovyapara for desirable, to get it and desire to get it off. Sankalpa. As a result, what it becomes? Vitaragaha. The one from whom raga is gone. Be careful about the word raga. Marathi raga means anger. Krodha, no. Raga here is asakti. Asakti, priti for sense objects, vishayas. Have you got priti or not? Vishayas. That is what is called as what? Raga. Vida raga, one who has no asakti, no at what we call attachment. Okay. And then asakti, no priti for vishaya. Why we have what priti? Just for like that. Our notion is that this object or this being or this event will give us happiness. Jivan Mukta has seen. It really cannot give. And when you know that it cannot give, why should you have asakti for it? Suppose something you know very well, something gives sorrow, have you got asakti? Parama vairagya. You don't have asakti at all, is it? But in his vision, Atma Swarupa Dhone Answarupa, nothing else can give happiness, he is not interested in them. See, that is very important. Vairagya can't come just like that. What is necessary for Vishaya Vairagya? Come on, at least like parrot you tell me. Dosha darshana. Buhu means repeatedly. Dosha darshana. Try to see the defects, dosha in the vishayas repeatedly. Convince your mind these vishayas are incapable of giving me joys. You may say, how is it possible? If I eat gulab jam, am I not happy? And you say, what vision is it? How do you say that? My dear sir, gulab jam has not given you happiness. You had the notion that you like gulab jam and it will make you happy. You eat. And therefore what you wanted it. And you eat it. Good. What happened was, temporarily, your this desire got fulfilled. Next desire is yet to come. Then what happens? That in that interval, intervening period, your Swarupa, which is Ananda, just was peeping out. What this fellow is doing? Oh, he said Ananda. And you thought that what? I got it from where? Gulabja. So, therefore, what I thought? Gulabja gives happiness. There was a miserable person having 450 blood sugar. So, I gave a plate of gulabja having 3 pieces. Happy? More miserable, you know why? He likes it. He knows I can't eat it. I can't eat it. Why the gulab jam should have given? Is our notion. Vishayeshu muhuhu muhuhu dosham sarsham. Now here in this case, it is long back dosha darshan has gone. Now he is seeing the swarupa, anand swarupa. Where is the desire for? Vitaraga, one from whom asakti is gone. See, other thing, This Vishayeshu Dosha Darshana is not an overnight job. You are asakta, you have got raga for vishaya since when? Anadikala. So, you have to struggle. For struggling, what is to be done? Somewhere break it through. You know, there, break through. Deuce break. What is that breakthrough? Somewhere is it. And it can be done at the indriya level. First, stop at the tasma tvama tvamindriyanyadav niyamya bhara darshana. So, beginning where? Indriya level. But that is not enough. It has to be supplemented by what? Further viveka, etc. It has to be supplemented to that. So, like that, no? Army attack. But there will second or this thing must be there. There must be a troop supporting the front army. Suppose it collapses, what happens? The other army, then they should move forward. And first Indriya Niyama. Then what? Supported by what? Viveka Vairagya. And for Viveka Vairagya, what necessary? Vichara. Move, dosha, darshana. So they say, vitaragaha, bhava, pick up. In this way, you will be able to enjoy the jivan mukti and you will not be afflicted by what? Bandhu, vadha, dukkha. Fine. Does it mean that I stop all the karmas? Because now jivan mukti. Kuch nahi karne ka. Sirf baithne ka. Khana bhi na karne ka. What is it? Says, no. Whatever karma that comes to you, as per your prarabdha, etc., or as per your stature in life, status in life, do it. Mind absorbed in the sorrow. So that is Dil mein Ram, haat mein kam. Dil mein Ram, mind is what? Haat mein? Which kam? Or start a new adventure. It doesn't come that way. What is expected of you depending on your status, etc. That you do it. But mind where? Absorbed in the soul. Let me say, continue.
Pravaha patitam karyam.
Idam
kinchit yathagatam.
Idam kinchit yathagatam.
Kuru karyani karmani.
Kuru karyani karmani.
Na kinchidiha nasyati.
Na kinchidiha nasyati.
Anvaya. Pravaha patitam. Idam karyam kinchit yathagatam karyani karmani kuru hiha na kinchit nasyati.
Say, do this. Pravaha patitam idam karyam. This duty, karya, thing to be done, which is what? Pravaha patitam. Literally, pravaha patitam means which has come to you as if a flow of thing. In the sense, like this. Shishta achara vyavahara parampara. Which has come to you as per the shishta achara vyavahara. How the people conduct themselves in accordance with the Dharma Shastra. For example, Arjuna. Who is Arjuna? Kshatriya. And not simple Kshatriya. Brother of who? Emperor. And what is the context? Empire has been usurped by Adharmi. So now, it is not getting back of the empire, putting down the Adharma. That is the duty of the emperor is to what? Establish the Dharma, punish the Adharmis. And you are the brother of who? Emperor. Not only brother ever, your brother has got all hopes in you. What will the Shishta expect? Do the yudha. That is what the context demands, sandarbha demands. So they will say, prava, that is, Shishta Vyavahara Paramparagatam. It is come with the parampara of the Vyavahara, the Shishta, those who know the Dharma Shastra. Idam Karya, what is Idam Karya? Yuddham, as far as Arjuna is concerned, this battle, Mahabharata, battle. Yuddham Karyam, what you do? Not only that, plus Kinchin Yathagatam Karyani. Some other Karyas, Yathagatam, as and when they come like Prarabdha. What are those? Yaga, Dana, Adini. Yaga, Yadde Yagas. The king has to do this. Dana, charity, so such thing. So, Yathagatam means as and when they come, not every day, sir. Yathagatam, Yathagatam, as and when they come. So, like Yadnayagas, charity, etc. Agatam, Kinchit Karyani, Karmani. What are the karma? Yaga, Dana, Adini. What you do? Kuru. Only because you do, don't think your Atma Jnana will get evaporated. You are not losing the Atma Jnana, Tattva Jnana, you are not losing. Therefore, I say, Iha na kinchit nashyat. Iha means Tattva Bodhe. As far as your Atma Jnana, Tattva Jnana, Tattva Bodhe. Not Tattva Bodha text only. Tattva Bodha text. So Tattva Bodhe in Atma Jnana, Tattva Jnana. What is that? Namaskrishna. Nothing you are losing it. Means if your vision is rooted in the Swarupa, these karmas be having done, nothing you are going to then we say, this is the nature of Jivan Mukta, let us see.
Pravaha patitam karma.
Pravaha patitam karma.
Swameva kriyate. Swameva kriyate tuyat.
Swameva kriyate tuyat.
Jivan Mukta swabhavoyam.
Jivan Mukta
Svabhavoyam.
Sa Jivan Mukta Tatatha.
Advaya. Pravaha Patitam. Tu Yat Swam Eva Karma Kriyate Ayam Jivan Mukta Svabhavaha Sa Jivan Mukta Tatha.
Now you know what is Pravaha Patitam Karma. Karma which comes to you as per Shishta Vyavahara Parampara. Pravaha Patitam. Pravatitam tu yat swam eva karma. Whatever karma which is pravatita, it will come like this. Swam means Swadharma. Swadharma means swakarma, means your duty. See, dharma also means karma. Dharma in general means what? Achara samhita, prescribed code of conduct by Vedas. See, having created this Srishti, Jagat, so Brahmaji gave a code of conduct. You have to conduct yourself like this. This thing you should do, this thing you have to. Then you can make best use of this. For example, a very sophisticated, costly machinery you have bought. Along with that, an instruction manual comes. What to do, what not to do, how to get the optimum benefit. What is the optimum benefit? Maximum benefit. Otherwise, why you have purchased the machinery? For me, is it not? So, who tells it? Instruction. So, Veda is the instruction manual for whom? Human being. What is to be done? What is not to be done? What is the goal of life? What are the means to accomplish that? All that is given. So that is there. So that is here. That is dharma, achara, samhita. In that, karma. Karma means what is to be done, what is not to be done. Swa karma. See, Lord Krishna said, sarva dharma paritejya mami ekam sharanam praja. And what we take dharma means religion. Krishna's time religion was there, not a Sanatana dharma only was there. Neither Christianity was there, nor Islam was there, nor Parsi, nothing was there. Where the religion comes there? Sarva karman pari. Give up all karma, surrender unto me, I will take care of everything. So, this word dharma is to be properly understood. You see, dharma is like the clothes we wear. It keeps the dignity of the human being. So here dharma means karma. Svakarma. So svadharma rupam karma. Swameva. Swameva karma kriyate. If one does such karma, priyate, I am means this person, this is what is jivan mukta svabhavaha. This is the nature of a person who is jivan mukta. What is the nature? Mind absorbs the swarupa, but as and when whatever karma comes to him, the doing of karma doesn't deprive him of the Atma Jnana Brahma. So, Jivatma, Swabhavaha, Swabhavaha. Sar, Jivan Muktata, Samina Prasiddha, Jivan Muktata. This is what status of being a Jivan Mukta. Tatha means it is of such nature. Means Jivan Mukti Avastha is of such nature as I have described to you. This is Jivan Mukta. As and when whatever comes, it is. What about other persons? Let me do this. Let me not do that. So that is not the Aviveki. That is the contrast.
Idam karma tyajami idam.
Idam karma tyajami idam.
Ashrayami iti nirnayaha.
Ashrayami iti nirnayaha.
Mudhasya manaso rupam.
Mudhasya manaso rupam.
Jnaninastu samastitihi.
Jnaninastu samastitihi.
Anvaya both lines as it is. Idam karma tyajami. idam ashrayami iti nirnayaha mudasya manasaha rupam jnaninaha tu samasthitihi.
Idam karma tyajami. This karma I will give up. I won't do that. Idam ashrayami. This I will resort to, means I will do it. Iti nirmaya. This nirmaya is whose nirmaya? Mudasya. Mudaya is adnyaha. Adnyani. Adnyani is where adhya talking about? Jivan mukta. Jnani with jivan mukta. Now, adnyani. In case of adnyani, says adnyani. Mudasya, adnyasya is mentality. Now come on, tell me, what is the deciding factor? I will do this, I will not do this. What is the deciding factor? Raga, asakti. His asakti, his raga, love for whatever he wants. This is not, I don't want that. I want this. So that was asakti. So when he has got asakti, what is his concept? Asakti for what? Vishayas. So what is the concept? Vishayas are going to make me happy. Cotton. So this is what? Mudasya. What is the mudasya? Manasaha rupam. In English you can say mentality. Mentality of an ignorant person is what? I will do this, I won't do this. Governed by what? Raga, asakti, vishayasakti. But whatever jnaninaha? Jnaninaha tu samasthiti. He is not tossed by this because he has no asakti. But whatever comes as per the context, he will do. For example, Arjuna, fight the battle. You might have got vairagya. You don't need the empire, but duty. Why? You have been a prince. You have to establish the dharma. Jnana sama. Sama means uniform. Sinha same means uniform sthiti. Further again description.
Shravapatitam karma. Kurvanta shanta chetasaha. Jivan mukta sushuptastaha. Surantyatra sushuptavat. Advaya, first line as it is, pravaha patitam karma urvantaha shanta chetasaha jivan muktaha sushuptasthaha atra spuranti. Atra is there. Atra sushuptavat spuranti.
We'll see next time.
Prajapya paripalayanta nyayena margena mahimahishaha go brahmarebhya shubhamastu nityam loka samasta sukhino bhavantu kale varshatu parjanyaha prithivi sasya sharini desho yam shobharahitah brahmanah santu nirbhayah om sarve bhavantu sukhinah sarve santu niramayaha, sarve bhadrani pasyantu, ma kaschid dukkha bhavate, asato ma sadgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityorma marutam gamaya, om.